still can go downstairs. Can't we?
Watch out, sir. It looks like the Romulans have taken control of the lower decks.
Okay. Can we unleash the gas on them? What do I do at this point?
That nozzle is for anti-agents only, Jim.
Nothing happens.
Oh, I work with this?
Careful, Jim. That's a distillator, not a can opener. Careful, Jim.
What can we do with this?
This looks like a primitive 20th century wrench still used by people who like to do things the old-fashioned way.
Is that a hint that McCoy should be using it?
This looks like a
I didn't know I was still in luck here.
Careful, Jim.
What am I doing with it?
That nozzle is for anti-agent.
Nothing happens.
This is a very well-equipped laboratory, Captain. Perhaps Dr. McCoy could be of some use here.
Thanks.
This level appears deserted, sir, but I'm worried about a Romulan counterattack.
Jim, this lab is incredible. What I wouldn't give to have some of this equipment on the Enterprise.
Okay, so I think we're supposed to be switching to McCoy, then, to do this crap.
I certainly see nothing there calling for ships, Doctor. I certainly see nothing there.
Well, Spock thinks you can do something with this stuff.
I certainly see nothing. Jim, these vile cultures are alive. I can use them to work on a cure.
Right, but how? I don't know what this crap is. If we want to isolate it, or whatever.
Nothing happens.
I'm not using on him. I'm trying to.
Nothing happens.
Oh crap! Okay, now.
Nothing
okay.
happens.
Hold on here. Switch to him.
Jim, these vile cultures are alive. I can use them to work on a cure. I certainly see nothing there.
Okay, In here, then. Is there anything you can do here, Bones? Even though Spock says we don't have to do anything here. Yes, go do something.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Fascinating, Captain. But it doesn't appear to get us any closer to our goal. Fascinating, Captain.
Okay. Well, there's these other... That's the other tank in the other room, but maybe we're supposed to unhinge one of these.
Gas feed is on.
Okay. Now what?
A gas tank marked O2.
You turn this one on, too?
Gas feed is off.
Okay, it's the same thing.
Gas feed is on. The machine synthesizes a liter of pure water.
A clean drink of water. But I don't see its application in the context of our difficulties, Captain.
Hmm. We need to turn the other one on, don't we? Can we take this, though?
You take a 1 liter container of pure water.
Yes, from the elemental plane of water. This is the most beautiful water you've ever drank. Look at it.
This blue container holds 1 liter of water.
Thirsty, Spock? You've been coughing. Oh, excuse me. Speaking of coughing, it makes my throat messed up. Can't analyze the water.
Nothing happens.
Let's turn... You know, what if we have both on? Let me go turn this on. I hope there's a way to make him move faster.
Nothing happens.
Oh, I want to turn it on.
Nothing happens.
Would that do something?
The tank detaches easily.
I guess this made it easier to replace the tank every so often, eh, Captain?
No, he said the other ones were too heavy. Can we take these, though? Or this?
The tank is too heavy to move by muscle alone.
What the hell else can we use? Can we slide a chair over?
You fail to obtain anything.
Isn't Spock very strong or something?
I fail to see the logic in that action, Captain. Nothing unusual is detected.
Can I turn this? No. All readings are normal.
This is the engineering center for the Arc 7 space station.
Okay. Well, we detached it, but we can't move it by muscle alone. Not sure what else to do at this point. Maybe we need to put the O2 here with the nozzle.
James Tiberius Kirk
needs to get out of the way so I can look at this.
This nozzle is where anti-agents are placed.
That's not an anti-agent, though. It's just water.
Nothing to report, Captain.
Can I turn this on?
There's no specimen in the chamber.
There's water. We need to put a specimen in the chamber. Okay, so we got a specimen, which is this. Now, operate the device.
You take the Ouroboros virus culture.
All I did was take it out again. Oh my god.
Nothing happens.
I'm not giving it to him. Okay. Out of the way. Just look at it.
This chamber is where virus samples are placed.
Indeed. Okay. Bones? Work the device.
This isn't the result I was hoping for, Jim.
We need something other than water, but how?
I certainly see nothing there calling.
He looks at you with a puzzled expression. He looks at you...
Sir, I think Dr. McCoy should run it. I may break it.
What about Spock in this situation?
A Hawking neutrino accelerator. It is one of the finest in production today.
Can we aim it down the stairs or something?
The virus has spread to me, Captain. I suggest you concentrate your efforts on the problem.
Well, that was messed up. He's so sick, his typing is messed up. Would love to concentrate on the problem. I don't know what to do about the problem.
Gas feed is off.
Hold up, hold up.
Nothing happens.
Fascinating, Captain.
I don't know what to do. So ultimately, it often happens in games like this.
I certainly see nothing there calling for a ship's doctor.
I end up not knowing what to do.
Nothing happens.
Can we open this? I mean, there's something that goes in there, right? Like a person?
Nothing to report, Captain. Nothing to report, Captain.
I really don't know what to do.
Spock, check out the station's computer and see what you can dig up.
So I assume it'd be the same thing you dug up last time.
Please select subject file. Ouroboros virus.
Oh! Okay, I have choices now. The virus.
TLTDH gas.
The gas.
Nitrous oxide.
Nitrous oxide.
Ammonia.
Ammonia.
Dihydrogen oxide.
Wow.
Exit database.
Okay.
Ouroboros virus.
Yeah, that one.
Ouroboros virus. Atypical growth patterns for L-type virus. Opportunistic pneumococcal mimic affecting Romulo-Vulcan genotype. Etiology, contact or airborne vector with alveoli microcollapse. Involvement immediately upon exposure. Tissue dehydration follows pneumal flooding. Mortality, 0.6 in 1.0 stardates. 1.0 within 2.0 stardates treatment, none. Named for the mythic world snake that swallows its own tail. Please select subject file. Ouroboros virus.
That's the snake, yeah. That's, I know I heard that before.
TLTDH gas. TLTDH gas. The chemical compound. Tantalum, bilithium, phthalo, dihydroxide. Colorless, odorless, non-flammable. Gaseous at 1 ATM. And temperatures within the human norm. Early anesthetic among Vulcans and Romulans, in whom it produces laughter. Feelings of exhilaration, euphoria, sometimes leading to unconsciousness. In post-industrial pre-spaceflight era, a social problem evolved when crude TLTDH became popular to cook up from non-conductive tantalithial compounds commonly used as electrical insulation. Please select subject file, Ouroboros virus.
Okay, yeah, this is definitely a longer episode than last time, because we already reached that, and I'm not going to be editing any of this stuff out, since it hasn't been boring as hell. Maybe a little bit, but...
TLTD nitrous oxide.
See?
Nitrous oxide. A colorless non-flammable compound. N2O. Gaseous at 1 ATM. And temperatures within the human norm. Early anesthetic among humans, in whom it produces laughter, feelings of exhilaration, euphoria, sometimes leading to unconsciousness. Please select subject file, Ouroboros virus.
Okay. So we've got O2 and we've got N2, I believe, so we can reproduce that, although we're the only humans on the ship, the rest is a Vulcan and... a bunch of, well, there are captured people. We don't want to capture them. We don't want to affect them with the gas. We want this gas.
TLTDH gas. TLTDH gas. The chemical compound. Tantalum, bilithium, phthalo, dihydroxide.
Gotta be the D2.
Colorless, odorless, non-flammable, gaseous at 1 ATM, and temperatures within the human norm. Early anesthetic among Vulcans and Romulans, in whom it produces laughter. Please select subject file. Ouroboros, T, nitrous oxide, ammonia. Ammonia. A colorless pungent compound, NH3.
NH3.
A common byproduct of metabolism in carbon-based life forms. Liquid or gaseous at 1 ATM. Compounds widely used in agricultural, medical, and industrial applications. Please select subject file. Ouroboros virus.
Now, I'm not sure. I've been hitting those tanks. And, I assumed it was one control. I mean, you can't tell by looking at it whether it's turned on or off. But maybe I am turning different tanks off and on, and it's just not specifying which tank. There are two of them.
TL, nitrous, ammonia, dihydrogen oxide. Dihydrogen oxide. A colorless, tasteless, non-flammable compound. H2O. Water. Liquid, solid, or gaseous at 1 ATM. Temperature scales defined in most humanoid cultures by state shift of pure water. Please select subject file. Ouroboros virus.
Okay, so we've made water.
TL, nitrous ammonia, dihydrogen oxide.
Or that.
Exit database.
Okay, so we got D2 and H2. This is H.
Gas feed is on.
H is on. Now I'm guessing D will be on.
Gas feed is off.
No, it just turns off. How do I turn them both on?
Gas feed is on. The machine synthesizes a liter of pure water.
A clean drink of water, but I don't...
Right, so H2O. But how do I use just one? And how do I get that other gas tank involved? We can't drag it. Hold on.
This chamber is where virus samples are placed. This device is used for the rapid reproduction of virus cultures in the presence of suspected anti-agents.
Right, so I want to make one of these anti-agents, which is one of these gases, I'm assuming, and put it in here. But, how do I get... Can I still not go down here? Let me save the game. I have not saved for a while.
Save new game.
What are we on? Episode 6? Excuse me. I'm getting a 2, Spock! I can't just go down, can I? Oh, they're all dead. Now we can go down. Maybe down here we can get something to help us move that gas tank.
You look but see nothing of note.
Yeah, nothing interesting here. Just a bunch of dead people.
These Romulans are totally out of it.
Or unconscious.
These Romulans are... This is the Ark 7's crew quarters. There are only Romulans here. This is the Ark 7's crew. These Romulans are totally. This is the Ark 7. This is the Ark 7.
Oop.
This door leads into another section of the base.
Apparently.
This is the Ark 7's.
So what are these?
This is the Ark 7.
We can't look at these things.
Well, there's a first time for everything.
First time for what?
Being surrounded by Romulans and not at gunpoint.
Really?
I have been in more comfortable situations, Captain.
I know, Mr. Spock, but we'll get through this.
We'll help you, buddy.
These Romulans appear to be a negligible threat, sir.
Whatever would make you say that? Ensign Ferris.
Damn it, Jim, I'm a doctor, not a diplomat. Got to try to save these men.
All right, save them. Are you going to wake them up and make them attack us?
Nothing to report, Captain. Nothing to report, Captain.
Jim, we've got to help these men before they die. Jim, we've got to help these men before they die.
Should we help them?
I don't have the proper medicine to cure them, Jim.
Didn't think so, but it was worth a try. Hello? That was a spooky sound.
This is a very advanced research laboratory.
No kidding.
This Romulan commander is unconscious. An odd-looking device, almost like a 20th century torpedo, fitted with an experimental gear.
My God, that's some kind of weapon.
Everyone on this project is an avowed pacifist, Doctor, myself included. We do not make weapons.
Well, it looks an awful like a weapon, gotta say.
Some odd-looking equipment connected to the torpedo.
What does this stuff do? What's going on here?
We're conducting research into the origins of life in the universe. This is our equipment. We believe that, well, I guess you don't have the time. You can get the background in my doctoral thesis.
Mm-hmm.
This is a very advanced... Dr. Anthony Cheever, Marcus's assistant. He has been bound by the Romulans.
Hey, does anyone in Starfleet know how to untie a knot?
I do. You just pull on the ropes until they're untied.
I don't care who does it, but could somebody get around to doing it on this star date?
Yes, you can do it yourself. Pull on the knots. Enjoy yourself.
Dr. Carol Marcus, head of this station's research team.
How about someone giving us a hand?
Hey, I wanted to look at you, not talk to you.
This is a very advanced...
Alright, so there's nothing else to really look at other than these people.
Some odd-looking equipment.
What does this stuff do?
We're conducting research.
This equipment, this torpedo.
Hello, Carol. It's good to see you again.
There was a time when I wouldn't have agreed with that statement. But I guess some things do get better with age.
You always could put me in my place, couldn't you?
Oh my.
That's the one thing I could never do. Your place was wandering the galaxy, and that's the one thing I could never give you.
Jim, get a handle on yourself. She's not a blue-skinned alien. Or a green-skinned alien. It's green skin, isn't it?
Fascinating equipment. I believe I have seen this sort of equipment someplace before.
We're testing the effect of radiation on combinations of simple and complex molecules. We're trying to see what new forms of life were developed and how they compare to our own early development.
Fascinating.
Somehow I knew he was going to say that.
Damn it, Jim, I'm a doctor, not a diplomat. These people will be fine. I've got to try to save the Romulans.
These Romulans appear to be a negligent...
Oh my God. Don't even. Just want to see if he says anything other than he can't help them.
He's infected with the virus too, Jim. They've been through a good deal of stress, but they're already starting to recover. Their heart rate is dropping and their blood pressure is also dropping. They've been through a good deal...
Nothing to report. Fascinating. This device contains over 10 million forms of life. Patterns I have never seen before.
Wow.
We call this the cradle, Mr. Spock. One day I hope something wonderful would be produced here.
10 what?
Fascinating.
We call this the
10 million forms of life? Holy crap.
Nothing to report, Captain.
This huge advanced console, you have nothing to report.
I detect no other life forms in the room, Captain.
Hey, would you please untie us?
Jim, it's you. Please untie us.
Okay, Ensign, please untie them.
He looks at you with a puzzled expression.
Untie them.
He looks at you with a...
Pull the knots. All right, fine, I'll do it. And he's like, blah, 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 blah.
Thank God it's you, Jim. I'm so glad you came.